we would like to graciously thank Her Royal Highness Princess Gwendolyn Murat of Vermont, Chief Alpha, also Colonel Zita Ilaikomia, the commander of the Royal Surgery Unit, and Captain Zita Lapunza, the Vice President of the Maryland Industrial Federation, Director of the Western Engineer of the Polo and the Western Bank.
And this has to turn in the board. We gracefully ask you all to step back from the board now, please. All the safety. The game is underway. Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. Back from the boards as soon as we can. The game is now underway. So here we go with the Anniversary Cup. It is Ty Polo on the ball, knocking it forward towards Caroline Lynch. Caroline Lynch running at it, but Pedro for 22 yards turns it down, but only as far. Driving forward, looking for William at the front. Claude gets his second hit. He's in front to goal, but he's going to the side. And the ball goes over the line and will be a hit in to Ty Polo. Ladies and gentlemen, can you please go a minimum of 10 metres away from the whiteboard, please? 10 metres from the whiteboard. As Ty Polo now attacks through Raoul in his distinctive back hat. He hits it through. He's looking for Caroline Lynch. Goes forward. Back goes Claude. The blue number two. Claude misses it. Caroline's a beautiful hit. There she goes. Leading Ty Polo forward. That's a beautiful hit inside. She turns. She's in front by the goal. But Claude comes across with some great defense. 22 yards. Now onto the ball. They turn it around. Flatu hits it hard. Comes over the board. Ladies and gentlemen, please be careful. Ponies will come over the board. That's why we need you 10 metres back, please. So again, Lau doing great stick work. Turns it around, releases it long. Caroline Lynch in a beautiful position. In front of goal, can she get there? Before it runs out of time, the answer is she can. But the ball bubbles and ends up on a 22-yard stick. Great defence there by 22-yard. They take it to the side, but they're still Ty Polo. Right in front of goal, forcing the play. They hit it, but once again, it's a couple of metres to the side of the post. So, this time, 22 BR, green fire release. They hit it, finds a vessel. Pedro, that's a huge hit, half the length of the field, looking for William. It's not quite long enough, allows Ty Polo to come in. Rule picking up the ball, looks ahead. Caroline goes forward, Harold goes forward. That's great play from Ty Polo again. They've got all the pressure, but it's yet they haven't got the goal. But we're only in the second minute of this first half. Back again, goes 20 yards. That's Blackwell. He's a great turnaround there. He hits it to Pedro. Pedro releases William. William's a great turn of speed. Gets himself clear. Pedro gets himself clear. But unfortunately, just to the right-hand side of the goal. So, end-to-end stuff, but the scoreboard still tells us it's 0-0 and all to play for. This time, it's Harold Link knocking in for Ty Polo. Two big hits from Harold. He goes wide. He collects the ball again. Harold gets it. He knocks it forward. He's looking for Carlos, but 22 BR, pick it up nicely there. Again, William right at the front. That's a great ball, but another difficult next shot. This time, too difficult, and it's picked up there by Ty Polo. Look at that, juggling the ball in the air. It's hard enough to hit it on the ground, and now they're volleying it. Here comes Harold at speed, watched by Claude. Harold decides to leave it, but that's not the best decision, because 22 BR, pick it up as Ty Polo go back. They collect the ball through Carlo. Carlo goes wide to the far side, looking for Rao. They've made it two-thirds of the way down. Now they've got to turn it around and go towards those small little orange sticks. That's where the ball's going to pass between. They're looking good. They're going for it. But once again, it's so close, but it's not in. So with 2 minutes 30 seconds of this, the first tracker, it's still tied. 22BR, they release it long to the side. It looks like Pedro goes across. William goes forward, Claude goes forward, but they're well marked by Caroline and Harold. The ball's knocked forward. Caroline takes out Claude, then goes to the ball, leaves it there for another member to come through, but Pedro's picked it up, but Rawl steals it off his stick. Rawl will turn it around now. He looks forward. Who's he got ahead? He's got Caroline. He's got Carlos. Carlos is going there, but Flacu is back. Great defense there by 22BR. Turn it around. How do you know Pedro was there? Because he's always there. He picks it up. He drives forward. He looks up. He looks for William in the middle. That's a big hit towards the goal. But not through the goal. And the score remains 0-0 with a minute and 30 seconds until the first chucker bell. So a tried and tested formula. They go to Harold Link at number four to knock it into Ty Polo. Harold plays it to Rawl. Rawl picks it up. Carlo goes ahead. That's a big hit. That's a beautiful hit. Caroline in a great position. Well ridden off by Claude, but that allows Carlos through the middle. But a bad bounce takes it away. And 22R through Flacu. Pick up the ball. Gets control. Look at that, ladies and gentlemen, on the half volley. Takes it to the far side. Now he slows his horse. He gets control of the ball. He looks inside. He's got two defenders to beat. That's too many. And Ty Polo take the ball off him. Again, Ty Polo now in the last minute of this, the first chucker. Rawl releases it. That is over 80 metres in length. Looking for Caro to go. But she decides to take a defensive role. Waiting for Flacu to turn it. Good decision by Caroline. She now picks up the ball. What great wisdom. She knocks it to the side. Wherever Caroline goes, Claude goes. But that allows Carlos in. Thailand, Ty Polo's number two. Turns it in. But then he leaves it for Rawl. Ty Polo's number three. Rawl hits it long, hard, high. But 1 metre to the left-hand side. So, as the first chucker bell goes, we still await our first goal. Ladies and gentlemen, there is a loose pony. Please look after your children until the pony is collected. There is a loose pony, ladies and gentlemen. So, ladies and gentlemen, we are seeing just how difficult this game is. On a pitch that is 300 metres long by 180 metres wide, and you have to hit a very small ball through a 12 metre gap. So, ladies and gentlemen, at the end of that chucker in polo, it is traditional and, in fact, the rules that every player will now change to a fresh pony, ready for the next chucker. Ladies and gentlemen, all the players have mounted onto beautiful, fresh, highly trained ponies. And we have 7 more minutes to decide this anniversary cup between Thai Polo in orange and 22BR in blue. So you will see that they have cantered down to the far left-hand side of the pitch. When the final chucker bell went, the whistle was blown, and the game will restart from the same position. So we are underway in this, the final chucker of the Anniversary Cup. It is the team in light blue, 22BR, who hit in. They go half the length of the pitch. Immediately it's William onto ball. William leads it for Claude. Claude robbed there by Rao from Thai Polo. Rao lifts it further than most people can hit a golf ball. It's all the way down there, but the wind has taken it to the right-hand side. So once again, 22BR will have the hitting. Claude moves to the left. William goes down the middle. In comes Flacu. Flacu, that's a big hit. He wants to get William moving. William's on a flyer. He's got great speed. He's in the clear. Caroline's chasing him down. But at the moment, William's in the clear. A bounce and leaves it there for Caroline. Caroline does just enough to stop Claude hitting it. But in comes Pedro. Pedro for 22BR, puts it out in front of the goal. Claude goes across. Claude hits the ball. The red flag waves. Ladies and gentlemen, 22BR score the first goal of the afternoon to lead this, the Anniversary Cup. When a goal is scored, both teams come back to the middle of the pitch. They will line up and the umpires will throw the ball between the two teams to restart the game. So 5 minutes 30 seconds left. Thai Polo are 1 goal behind. The ball goes in. It's picked up once again by 22BR. It is again Flacu. Flacu knocks it long. William playing a very forward role today. Gets onto the ball. That's a good first hit. But then it bobbles to the side. Back goes Thai Polo. Raul turns it round. That's a big hit. Caroline, great positioning. Caroline gets onto it. She's got Carlos behind her, so she leaves it. But Carlos is ridden away there by Claude. Claude knocks it back, but only as far as the number 3 for Thai Polo, Raul. Raul releases it long. Caroline very cleverly snuck away. She's unmarked. She's in the clear. She's got the ball in front of her. Can she get this through the goal to level for Thai Polo? It's looking good. The answer is, oh my goodness, on the line. 22BR knock it away, but there's still danger as Thai Polo go forward this time with Harold Link. And that was a very difficult shot. A cut shot that went just millimetres wide. But the answer is 22BR with 4 minutes to go. Still have the slender lead of just 1 goal. So as they go forward again, 22BR, William rides over it, leaves it cleverly for Pedro. Pedro knocks it forward for William. This is great teamwork. Now William's in the clear. He's got speed, he's got the ball. Can he put it between the sticks? No, he's shepherded there by Caroline Link. But that does mean that Thai Polo now have the hit in. They've got 300 metres to go to the other end of the pitch and they need a goal within the next 3 minutes or this Anniversary Cup is slipping away from them. Now you'll see just how quickly they can cover 300 metres. Look at this, flat out. 40 kilometres, 50 kilometres an hour. Look at that for a hit. That's 2 hits. He's bending, he's turning, but it's not going in. So Tai Polo putting all the pressure on, but they still don't have the goal they need. 22BR, with 3 minutes left, are holding on. This time, Flacu, he dribbles before releasing a bit longer. He's looking there for Claude. Claude rides off, leaving it for Pedro. Pedro hits it nice along towards the corner. 22BR want this ball away from their goal. Caroline goes back. Caroline has a little tap. That turns it round. There is the number three for Tai Polo, Raul. He turns a beautiful shot. Harold Link, great positioning. Harold Link, a great hit. He's coming towards the far side. He's got the ball. He's got speed. He's on his way. Across comes William to defend. But so far, Harold's still on his way. Another great hit as William comes to mark him. But where is the ball? It's still in play. We wait for the flag. It's still in play. Who's there? Caroline Link picks it up. She's in front to goal. She taps it all the way across. Oh, and 22BR get a stick to it right on the line. It could not be closer for Tai Polo, but they still await their first goal of the afternoon. There's a huge hit. Again, it's in front of goal. Is it in front of goal? No, it's to the left-hand side. So 22BR, look at the clock. It's ticking. It says 1 minute 30 seconds. That's a lot of time in polo, but Tai Polo still need this goal. Back goes Raul. He turns on it. He looks forward. Harold goes forward. Caroline goes forward. They're both in there. Here comes Harold. Harold's in front of goal. That's a good connection. Caroline following up. That's great teamwork. Ladies and gentlemen, the score is 1-1. Tai Polo get the equalising goal with just a minute to go of this anniversary cup. So both teams canter back to the middle of the pitch. Umpire JJ will throw it between. Have either team got enough time to get a winning goal in this, the anniversary cup? All important in the lineup. Who's going to get the ball? The answer is it's Harold. Harold picks it up. Not only does he pick it up, he then goes away. Harold in the clear. Two good hits. Leaves it there for Caroline. Caroline ridden off, but still gets contact. Well done there by Claude. And 22BR then through Pedro take the ball to the far side. The clock is ticking. It says 15 seconds. Can they go the length of the pitch? 22BR are trying, but the time is against them. That's a big hit. Caroline is well marking. Beautiful marking. Takes the man off the ball, allowing her pro to pick the ball up. As, ladies and gentlemen, the whistle goes, which brings the anniversary cup to a conclusion with a score of Tai Polo 1, 22BR 1. Traditional sporting manner, the teams now go and congratulate each other and then they will come to the board. Give a big round of applause to these two teams. Tai Polo, represented by Caroline, Harold, Carlos and Roll, and 22BR, represented by William, Claude, Flacu and Pedro. Ladies and gentlemen, before the next game begins, there will be a quick presentation of the B-Dream 140 years anniversary cup. Teams, please come to the middle for your presentation.
camera, do not use your phone. Please do not take the photo of Her Royal Highness. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, if you can now be outstanding, please, for the presentation of the B. Grimm Anniversary Cup by Her Royal Highness the Princess. Ladies and gentlemen, as that was a very competitive draw, we ask for one member of 22BR and one member of Typolo to step forward and receive the Anniversary Cup from Her Royal Highness the Princess. So, ladies and gentlemen, can you please put your hand together for the official photo of all six teams in this year's Typolo Open 2018, kindly sponsored by B. Grimm Limited and Carrier Air Conditioners. Thank you. So, ladies and gentlemen, on Thursday, we had two electric semi-finals. The winners of those semi-finals will compete for the final this afternoon. But before that, we have the runners-up from the semi-finals to play in the Subsidiary Cup to decide third and fourth place in this year's Thai Polo Open. Those two teams are one from China called Fast Fish. They will wear their white shirts and be represented by at number one, Winston, number two, Rodrigo, number three, Nico, and number